गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर एसएससी टीचर मिसेस मंजू शर्मा एंड टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आवर सेकंड चैप्टर इन सिविक्स ऑफ क्लास 7th, डेमोक्रेसी इन इंडिया. चिल्ड्रन, एज वी हैव स्टडी द बेसिक्स ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी इन आवर प्रीवियस चैप्टर एंड वी आर अ डेमोक्रेटिक कंट्री. Our democracy is on the lines of representative democracy. This is the most commonly practiced form of democracy in the world. And in this chapter, we shall now see how democracy works in India. With the gaining of independence, we saw a new era in the history of India. From being a colony of British Empire, India emerged as a republic and chose to have a democratic form of government. It was to be the largest democracy of the world. So first we will know what is the meaning of democracy. So the students, democracy refers to the rule of the people, and the right to vote is a means to establish and continue the rule of the people of a country. And in this chapter we will explore how people exercise their right to vote through the process of election and other terms. First of all, we see the first topic, universal adult franchise. In simple terms, the word universal refers to all citizens. Adult means the age of adulthood, and franchise means vote. Thus, it means that all adults of the country have the right to vote and elect their representative in the government. Now we will see how the elections consist in our country. The procedure to organize voting by the public for the formation of the government is called election, and the election could be any one of the next following terms. First, the general election. These are elections held for electing the leaders who would represent the people in the parliament. Since they are held all over the country at once, they get are known as general election. The second elections are midterm elections. And these elections could be held immediately to elect a fresh government. Such elections, which are held before the completion of the full term of the government, are called midterm election. The next is by-election. The elections which may be held for a specific or limited seats for a specific reason are known as by-election. So there are three types of elections: general elections, mid elections, and by-elections. Now we will know who conduct the elections in India. So we will read about Election Commission. Elections are organized by the Election Commission, which is a statutory body. This means that the functioning of the Election Commission cannot be interrupted with the government in the power. And the function of the Election Commissions are: the Election Commission is responsible to announce the schedule of elections. It gives out the schedules for filling nomination papers. The commission spells out a date for withdrawal of candidature also. People who wish to contest the election file their nomination and deposit a security amount. And so many works that our election commissions do in the contesting election. The next topic is secret ballot. The people have the power to keep it secret as to whom they are voting for. The place where the vote is to be cast is scheduled, and no one is allowed in that place to see whom citizen voted for. And for this, the voting machine do not ask for any details of the person casting the vote. It just has button in front of the names and party symbol of each candidates. Now the question is, who formed a government? Majority, when an election is conducted, some political party or a group of parties has more number of seats as compared to others. The party or the groups of parties which has more than 50% of the seats share of the house is to said have absolute majority, and it forms the government. Now the question is, who can contest the election and who would be the candidate in election? A person who wishes to contest in the election and gets his name registered for the purpose is called a candidate. He or she has to fulfill the conditions laid down by the constitution to be eligible to contest election. The next and important part of the elections are political parties. Political parties are a group of people who agree on some policies formulate an agenda and program for the society with a view to promote collective good. Different political parties may have different theories on policies on how the government should be run. Political party seeks to implement these policies by winning popular support through elections. Now, we will study about the functions of the political parties. They contest election by putting up their selected candidates. The political parties offer different policies and programs. They organize and hold elections, rallies and door-to-door campaigning. The political parties whose number of candidates elected in more than the other is called the majority party, and those with lesser number of elected candidate is called the minority party. The majority party forms and runs the government. The political party which does not get majority plays the role of opposition in the parliament. Now, a new terms of government in our country is coalition government. A political party getting the majority of votes forms the government. If a situation arises that no political party gets enough members to form the government, then a few political parties join together to form the government. Since they had announced different policies and manifestos to people before election, they usually consult each other and come to a consensus on how to run the government and which policies to implement it. So, coalition government is now a popular form of government in our country also. The political party that is in majority or the coalition party is majority elects their leaders, who at the state level is called the chief minister, and the central government level is called the prime minister. Now we will study the state wise number of parliamentary constituencies. The list is here and you can read it carefully and know the constituencies in the different state of our country. So thanks and goodbye, students.